feet of Christ. Thanks be to God. The light of Christ. Thanks be to God. The light of Christ. Thanks be to God. The light of Christ. Thanks be to God.
My name is the Reverend Nigel Irons, and it's my pleasure to welcome you to St. Edward's Church in Leek on this Easter Sunday. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. And so we sing our first hymn. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Christ, our Passover Lamb, has been sacrificed for us. Let us therefore rejoice by putting away all malice and evil and confessing our sins with a sincere and true heart.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen.
And so may God, our Heavenly Father, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Collect for Easter Sunday. Lord of all life and power, who through the mighty resurrection of your Son overcame the old order of sin and death to make all things new in him, grant that we, being dead to sin and alive to you in Jesus Christ, may reign with him in glory, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be praise and honour, glory and might, now and in all eternity. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Our Old Testament reading is taken from the book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 25. On this mountain, the Lord Almighty will prepare a feast of rich food for all peoples, a banquet of aged wine, the best of meats, and the finest of wines. On this mountain, he will destroy the shroud that enfolds all peoples, the sheet that covers all nations. He will swallow up death forever. The Sovereign Lord will wipe away the tears from all faces. He will remove his people's disgrace from all the earth. The Lord has spoken. In that day they will say, "Surely this is our God. We trusted in him, and he saved us. This is the Lord. We trusted in him. Let us rejoice and be glad in his salvation." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our New Testament reading is taken from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 15. Now, brothers and sisters, I want to remind you of the gospel I preached to you, which you received, and on which you have taken your stand. By this gospel you are saved, if you hold firmly to the word I preached to you. Otherwise, you have believed in vain. For what I received I passed on to you as of first importance, that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day according to the Scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas, and then to the 12. After that he appeared to more than 500 of the brothers and sisters at the same time, most of whom are still living, though some have fallen asleep. Then he appeared to James, then to all the apostles, and last of all, he appeared to me also, as to one abnormally born. For I am the least of the apostles, and do not even deserve to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am what I am. And his grace to me was not without effect. No, I worked harder than all of them, yet not I, but the grace of God that was with me. Whether then it is I or they, this is what we preach, and this is what you believed. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
And now we'll sing our second hymn.
Rejoice, rejoice, let every
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. On the first day of the week, very early in the morning, the women took the spices they had prepared and went to the tomb. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb, but when they entered, they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. While they were wondering about this, suddenly two men in clothes that gleamed like lightning stood beside them. In their fright, the women bowed down with their faces to the ground. But the men said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here. He has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still with you in Galilee, 'The Son of Man must be delivered over to the hands of sinners, be crucified, and on the third day be raised again.'" Then they remembered his words. When they came back from the tomb, they told all these things to the 11 and to all the others. It was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary the mother of James, and the others with them who told this to the apostles. But they did not believe the women, because their words seemed to them like nonsense. Peter, however, got up and ran to the tomb. Bending over, he saw the strips of linen lying by themselves, and he went away, wondering to himself what had happened. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful day, and we pray now that as we reflect on the gospel account of that first Easter, you will meet us afresh in the power of your Holy Spirit and give us ears to hear, minds to understand, and hearts to receive your truth. In Jesus' name, Amen. A family of porcupines are setting up for an Easter party, but they're having some problems. So one of them says to another, "How about we forget the balloons? Who needs balloons anyway?" Well, today, Christians all over the world, with or without balloons, will joyfully celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, from the dead. Today is the most glorious of all days, because when Jesus came back to life, he also made it possible for everyone who believes in him to receive new and eternal life for themselves, and to know that when they die, they will also come to receive a new resurrection body like his, so that they can live forever with him in his eternal kingdom, free from death, free from suffering, free from pain, free from injustice, free from anything and everything that might cause them harm. That is the promise of Easter. And that is why we celebrate it with such joy. Easter is the most significant, the most wonderful, and the most amazing event that has ever happened in the history of the world. And it happened very early in the morning. How many of you have ever got up very early in the morning? Well, there are lots of reasons why we may choose to get up very early in the morning. Maybe we are going on a journey and need to get somewhere in time to catch a coach or train or ship or aeroplane. If that journey is for a holiday or to visit a friend or to watch a special event, then we will be very excited about it. But not all journeys are like that. Sometimes we may be going to an interview where other people will decide if we are the right person to study at a particular university or do a particular job or join a club or society of some kind. And in that case, we will feel very nervous about what the outcome will be. At other times, we may go on a journey to visit a friend who is very ill, or to meet family members who are grieving because someone they love has died. Those kinds of journeys make us feel sad. And it was that kind of journey that a small group of women made very early in the morning on that first Easter day. They were sad because they were going to the tomb where their close friend, teacher and leader, Jesus, was buried. He had been killed just a couple of days before and placed in the tomb quickly because the Sabbath, the Jewish day of rest, was about to begin. There hadn't been time to wrap Jesus' body with all the spices that were normally used, so they were going to the tomb to do that. Jesus had changed so many people's lives, including their own. He had healed many people who were sick, including some of them, and had taught them about the good news of the kingdom of God, which is the best news anyone can ever hear. News about forgiveness. News about freedom. News about life in all its fullness. And Jesus had come to make all these things possible for everybody who chooses to believe in him. The women had no idea how they would move the huge stone away from Jesus' tomb, but when they got there, they found that it had already been rolled away. So they went inside. But when they went in, they couldn't find the body of Jesus anywhere. It had gone. They were confused, puzzled, and very distressed. What had happened to Jesus' body? Who had taken it? Where was it? And then, suddenly, without any warning, two men in bright, shining clothes were standing next to them. They were angels. And whenever people in the Bible see an angel, they are afraid. Because angels are amazing beings from beyond the world we know. And they shine with the glory of God because they live in the presence of God. The angels gave the women this amazing message. Why are you looking among the dead for one who is alive? He is not here. He has been raised. Remember what he said to you while he was in Galilee. The Son of Man must be handed over to sinners, be crucified, and 3 days later, rise to life. Well, Friday had been the first day when Jesus died. Saturday had been the second day, and it was now Sunday, the third day when Jesus had said he would rise from the dead. By the power of the Holy Spirit, God the Father healed Jesus' body from all his wounds and breathed new life back into him. So now the women were no longer sad. They had thought that they were going to complete Jesus' burial, but in fact they had been on a journey to hear the incredible news that Jesus was in fact no longer dead, but alive, just as he had said. They hadn't believed it when he had told them before, because it was impossible that anyone could rise from the dead. But now, the impossible had happened, and they ran back to the other disciples to pass on the message that the angels had given them. At first, the disciples just couldn't believe what the women told them. But Peter ran to the tomb to see for himself and found everything just as the women had said. Of course, that's not the end of the story. There's more. Because his disciples found it so hard to believe that anything like this could happen, Jesus appeared to them in his new resurrection body. The Bible tells us about 13 times when Jesus appeared to different people, usually small groups of disciples, but once to a crowd of over 500. He reassured them that it was really true. The power of death had been overcome. He was alive again, forever. Like the women who went to the tomb, we are all on a journey together. The journey of life. And as we make that journey, we will feel all kinds of different emotions. Hatred and love. Sadness and joy. Anxiety and peace. But the thing is that whatever emotions you are feeling right now, at this time in your own journey of life, Jesus wants to bring you the same good news that he brought to the women who made the journey to the tomb. Jesus wants us all to know that he is alive. That because he is alive, we can be forgiven. That because he is alive, we can know him. That because he is alive, we can be made new. That because he is alive, we can live for him instead of for ourselves. That because he is alive, we can receive the promise of eternal life. That's why Easter is so exciting and so challenging too. Because we have to make the choice, like the first disciples did, whether we believe Jesus or not. But Jesus has promised to everyone who does choose to believe him that they will be brought out of darkness into his glorious light, and we'll be able to discover what life is really about as they live it with him. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for making us and loving us and showing yourself to us and wanting what is best for us. Help us to seek you and to find you, to know you and to trust you, to listen to you and to live for you day by day. Jesus, thank you for overcoming the power of death once and for all by rising from the dead and coming back to life. Open our eyes to the truth you came to show us and be our guide so that we can learn to live for you rather than for ourselves. Holy Spirit, thank you for bringing Jesus back to life, and that because of everything he has done, we can now receive new life too. Help us to believe in him, to trust in him, and to open ourselves to the power of his love at work in our lives every day. Amen.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory, to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
And now we'll sing our third hymn.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Blessed are you, God and Father of us all, giver of life and life eternal. By the love of your Son, you have triumphed over hatred. In his power, light has conquered darkness, and life has overcome death. You have opened for us the gate of eternal life. Blessed are you, O God, now and forever. Lord of life, hear our prayer. We give you thanks and praise for the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ and for his appearances to his loved ones. We rejoice with the whole church in the joy of the risen Lord. May we who know the good news go and tell others that he is risen. Grant that your church may help to bring peace and hope to our troubled world. And we ask you to give courage to all who have not seen and yet believe. Lord of life, hear our prayer. Risen Lord, we seek your peace. Peace for our war-torn world. Peace between nations and people. Peace in our dealings with each other. Peace in our hearts and homes. Peace in the midst of our turmoil and uncertainty. Lord of life, hear our prayer. As you appeared to the disciples in the house, come, enter our homes. Come, enter into our fear and darkness. Come, enter into our enclosed lives. Come with the glorious freedom you offer to the children of God. Lord of life, hear our prayer. We come with all who weep by gravesides, all who mourn the loss of a loved one, all who feel lonely, isolated, or deserted. May all who mourn find new hope and joy in you. We remember all who are ill at this time, and those who are caring for them. We pray for those who have a heavy weight on their hearts and minds, and tears in their eyes. We ask that we may all know the hope of eternal life. Lord of life, hear our prayer. We rejoice with the disciples and all your saints in the joy of the risen Lord. We ask you to bless us and all whom we love. Strengthen us to follow in the footsteps of all the saints until we meet with them and enjoy the fullness of your light and peace in your eternal kingdom. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
God of life, who for our redemption gave your only begotten Son to the death of the cross, and by his glorious resurrection have delivered us from the power of our enemy, grant us so to die daily to sin, that we may evermore live with him in the joy of his risen life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Lord, give us eyes to see the hidden glory, which delights to be discovered by the seeking heart, which shines unceasingly and without change or shadow. The glory of a life transformed, a heart touched, a mind renewed. The glory of a man nailed to a cross in agony of death, surrendering his life in place of ours, accomplishing the impossible, breaking the captive chains of sin, changing the face of eternity in one brief moment of time. The glory of a tomb, emptied of the one it held for a brief span in its dark ocean of silence, now filled with a shining light and shouting a message of hope, rising above all other voices. Lord, give us eyes to see this glory. And as we gaze, renew our minds, touch our hearts, and transform our lives. In Jesus' name, Amen.
And so may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and in the love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father who has created us, the Son who has redeemed us, and the Holy Spirit who breathes God's life, light, and love into our hearts, rest upon you, remain with you, guard you, guide you, keep you, and strengthen you in his service, today and always. Amen. Thank you for joining us this morning. We extend a warm invitation to you to join us again next week for our service of morning worship. And may the peace and joy of Easter travel with you.